Hey everyone, Get the Gameplay here, and we're back, and I'm back here in Jurassic Park, and we're on to episode 3. The Depths. Begin! I have been so long since I played this, I have no idea where I left off. Alright, chopper crash. That's what you think. People. We'll be okay.
How you holding up, honey?
I want to go home.
I know, sweetheart. Me too. We'll be fine. I promise.
Man, they're raptors! Look!
God! Trying to bring the tower down!
It'll hold. It's got to.
Yeah, well, I don't want to take any chances.
Don't count on it.
Need to get off the tower before the raptors bring it down.
The emergency ladder's right there. The way the tower is tilting, it will put us down outside the pad.
That's a start, but the fence isn't much of an obstacle for the raptors. Where do we go once we're out?
I think we can make it to the utility tunnels, right over there. We can lock the raptors
out
and keep them inside.
I hope you're right. Let's get that ladder lowered.
Oh god. Yeah, this is so not gonna work.
Won't budge.
Did you try the latch?
The latch. Right. Of course.
Ah, that would explain it.
That should free it up.
It won't budge?
It still won't move.
It's brand new, so it might still be a little stiff. Maybe if you put more weight on it?
What, you mean stand on it?
Oh, that's not a good idea.
Yes, ride it down.
Okay, but we should probably be ready to move as soon as it comes down so we can stick together. Oh. Sweetheart, listen. I want you to be ready to climb down the ladder as soon as it's extended.
Okay, Dad.
Dr. Sorkin.
I'll be right down.
It's really stuck. Oh, no, I see the problem. The whole ladder is just slightly bent. It can't slide freely. We might be able to force it.
Must have been the crash.
Looks that way. I think we're gonna need a crowbar or something to get it open.
Oh, well then we're gonna have to get creative because there are no tools up here.
Alright,
This antenna could be just the thing we need to pry the ladder open. But if I try to grab it now, I could get electrocuted.
Yeah, that sure would suck.
Hurry!
Okay, Turn power off.
Dr. Sorkin, that antenna is the only thing up here I've seen that we can use to pry the ladder open. Is there any way to turn the power to those lights off so I can grab it?
Not from up here. The aircraft alert beacons aren't ever supposed to be disabled. The best I can do is make them flash on and off.
How?
I can switch them from nighttime to daytime operation. They shine continuously at night, but during the day they flash to provide more contrast.
All right, then let's do it.
Okay, I've switched the beacon lights to daytime mode. Hopefully that wire won't be live while the lights flash off.
Oh, frick. Don't grab it.
See him!
Jump the gun a little.
Alright, let's try that again, shall we?
Have to time it just right.
There you go.
Got it.
If I couldn't move it by jumping on it, I'm never going to be able to pry it by myself.
Dr. Shorten?
Yes?
Can you give me a hand with this? You pry while I put my weight on the ladder.
Certainly.
Okay, Dr. Sorkin, I'm ready. Jess, honey, you get ready to move as soon as the ladder goes down.
I'm ready, Dad. Just hurry.
Okay, Dr. Sorkin, on three. Ready?
One, what's next with his eyes?
Two, three.
Off. All right.
That was my fault. I didn't time it right.
Dad, what are we gonna do?
Try again. On three. Ready? One, two, three. No, Jess, wait! No!
I'm fine, Dad!
Oh, you better leg it.
Dr. Sorkin.
I'm coming down.
Uh-oh. Jeez it!
Dr. Sorkin, you have to hurry!
Out of the way! I'm gonna jump for it!
Oh, frick.
Thanks.
Okay, now up and over.
I'm okay.
Alright, now leg it.
Run, Dr. Sorkin!
Run!
The door.
Oh.
Stop, Billy!
Next time I get a headache like this, there better be tequila involved.
No way, amigo. This turned out better than the last time you drank tequila.
Yeah, might be right. The girl I woke up next to is prettier anyway. So, we lost our ride, and the only person we managed to rescue so far doesn't even work for InGen. Now what?
See if you can find anything useful in the wreck. And make sure the girl's okay while I scout the perimeter.
Ah, damn it, I left my AK inside the chopper. It's probably toast. Glad I didn't leave a round chambered. Could have killed someone.
That makes two of us, amigo. Still, the cook-off was a hell of a show.
Oh, rip chopper.
Gonna take more than an auxiliary power unit to fix her this time. Better keep checking her out. If she's gonna blow, we don't want to be anywhere nearby. No fuel left. Must have been a hell of a blast. Looking pretty safe. One more look, just to be sure.
Thought someone were to the left. There.
Damn it. All our weapons were in there. I was just getting used to that AK, too. That chopper's done all the exploding she's ever gonna do. Should be safe to make camp here. I should see if the girl's okay.
Check the bag.
Barbasol. I have a can just like this back in San Jose. Oh, man. I hope it's not for her face. Heavier than I remember. Could just be full, I guess. It's only sloshing at the top. Sounds half empty, feels full. Why is that? My stepbrother used to store his second set of keys in a fake pop can. I wonder. The lady has a secret stash. Well, what the hell is it?
Uh-oh. That's not gonna be good.
T-Rex, it's leaving.
Damn it, Oscar. I only have one pair of pants. The chopper's not gonna blow, but just about everything in it, including our weapons, is flame broiled.
No game trails, no nests. This is base camp for now.
Hey, get this. I found this can of shaving cream in her back.
Didn't think you needed any.
Yeah, whatever you say, Fuzzy. Except it's not really shaving cream. Look. So, now what's the plan?
What's the plan?
You gonna try to salvage this gig?
Yeah. I'm gonna go look for our friends.
Shouldn't I come with?
We lost the guns. Means I gotta be in stealth mode.
You saying I can't sneak?
I'm saying neither one of us can sneak and watch her at the same time. Besides, she won't talk with me around. But maybe pretty boy Billy can get her to open up.
Yeah, it's a tough job.
That door's locked.
They open doors.
Didn't they lock the door?
Stayed in bed.
Oh, I almost fucked that up. That's not gonna budge.
Smart.
Oh, copy.
I feel real. Oh, my bad.
Where'd Billy go?
He left me alone. Idiotas. At least one of them pulled me out of there. Not sure I'd do the same.
Where's the can?
Nieta! No, no, no!
Looking for this?
That's mine!
You know, this takes me back. I learned to shave with this stuff.
Give it back! Now!
I'm all out of shaving cream myself. You mind if I borrow some?
Stop shaking it!
But you're supposed to shake it before you use it. Says so right on the can. You want to tell me what's so important about shaving cream? Or do I ask Injun?
Embryos.
Embryos! Dinosaur embryos. If you drop them, they'll be destroyed.
Embryos, huh? Wow. I knew you were up to something, but this is pretty clever, I gotta admit. Injun's gonna love me for bringing this back. Talk about a bonus.
Look, Yoder. Billy, right? Maybe we can make a deal.
This ought to be good. Shoot.
Daddy's grief right now. You should be nice about it.
Please! I don't expect you to trust me, but the right thing to do is to give it back to me and let me go.
One merc to another.
One mercenary to another. Would you do any different in my place? Everyone can win here. Let your friends save those people while we sell the embryos.
Look, lady, we both have jobs to do. Thing is, in this situation, I'm the cop and you're the robber.
Injun stole this land from my people. Relocated them at gunpoint. Do you know what you get when you take a tribe out of the jungle? Poverty. Unrelenting, crushing poverty with no way to escape.
Oh, Dios.
You really want to support a company that would do that?
You're not the only one who's had a rough life, lady. InGen may have screwed you, but they pay my bills. And besides, from what I hear, they rented this place from the Costa Rican government. Why don't you take it up with them?
No, must reveal the daughter.
I have a daughter. I need the money to get her out of the ghetto. You know what happens to girls there. She doesn't deserve that life.
Are you for real? Okay, keep talking.
He's greedy?
There's a lot of money in it for you if I get those embryos to my contact before they go bad.
Home story.
You turn that over to InGen. You get a pat on the back, maybe a little Christmas bonus. You leave it to me, you become a rich man. Pay off your debts, quit your job. No more guys in suits telling you what to do. Just think about it. Come on, Billy. The money's good. And you'll be helping me save my daughter. Everybody gets a little something.
Everybody's a winner.
Okay, here's the deal. One, I'm in charge. I keep the embryos. And as soon as it's safe to break away, we'll deliver them to your contact.
I don't know if the embryos will last in there much longer.
That's a risk we're gonna take. Two, we're cutting Oscar in.
Why?
Because he's my partner, that's why. It'll be fine. Trust me. Now sit tight and lighten up. Not every woman gets to enjoy the sunset on a tropical island with Billy Yoder.
So, any idea where we are in relation to the rest of the park?
We're not far from the marine exhibit. I know for a fact that the phone there is in working order, or at least it was this morning.
Don't count on it.
Did we get there from the tunnels?
I believe so.
All right then, lead the way. Want to get us out of here as soon as possible. No more science projects, okay?
I understand.
Don't worry, Jess. We should be safe in here.
Where do all these doors lead?
The maintenance corridors. The park's essential systems are in there. Electrical, water, air conditioning, you know, that sort of thing.
The tunnels on this side are for transporting animals, personnel, and food. That's why they're so big. They're separate from the maintenance side to prevent accidents.
Are you sure we shouldn't head to the visitor center, Dr. Sorkin? InGen is bound to start there when they don't hear from the rescue team.
These tunnels don't run all the way to the visitor center, and I don't know about you, but I'd rather not risk any more overland travel.
Good point. Well, as long as we're getting to know one another, how is it that Dr. Wu became chief geneticist over you?
That's an easy one. Frogs.
You're saying frogs kept you from getting promoted?
Specifically, their DNA. Before we could clone any dinosaurs, we had to decide how to fill in the gaps in the DNA sequences we found.
I remember this from the tour. You found dino blood inside mosquito fossils, right?
That's right. I wanted a complete prehistoric genome, cross-referencing all of the DNA found in the various amber samples. It would have been safer, but would have taken time the board of directors didn't want to spend.
Well, even Dr. Hammond's spare-no-expense philosophy has limits, I guess.
Exactly. Henry, Dr. Wu, proposed using frog DNA to fill in the gaps. It was risky. We still don't know all of the effects. But it was a solution, and a fast one at that. So Henry became chief geneticist, and I took to the field. Has anyone seen my cigarettes? I could swear I had some.
Smoke.
I didn't realize you smoked.
Normally, I manage to duck out a few times a day, but we've been preoccupied.
Where did you last have them?
Right here in my pocket, or so I thought.
Maybe they fell out when we jumped from the water tower?
I suppose.
Uh-oh.
Oh well, I'm probably better off without them.
Oh, she's got cigarettes.
So, Laura, I've been meaning to ask you, why don't you do your radio show anymore?
You had a radio show?
Well, it wasn't really radio. I'd hack into the park intercom and play choice cuts from my record collection.
Oh, that rat's gonna die.
Lately, I haven't had the time.
Did you really have to show Artie Bridges how to do it?
Believe me, I regret it. But how was I to know how bad he was? He begged me, said it was his dream to be in radio.
You know what, he should stick to managing the janitorial group. He is awful.
He certainly is.
Chomp.
I guess there was a reason it was just a dream. He actually records his show ahead of time so that he can broadcast during work hours.
Did you guys hear that?
Sounded like a rat.
Mm-hmm. Dinosaurs aren't the only invasive species InGen brought to the island. There are lots of rats in these tunnels. Maintenance is always setting traps down here. Do you mind if we stop for a rest? My legs are killing me.
I suppose we could all use a break.
I don't know how much longer those embryos will last. We need to meet my contact at the boat.
We're staying here until Oscar gets back.
We don't even know if he's alive.
Oscar's fine. He's coming back. And come hell or high water, we are not leaving.
What about Tyrannosaurus?
Then again, maybe you have a point.
Come on, we gotta run!
No time! Hide!
Oh god.
Care for a lysine supplement?
No thanks. But you know what? Actually, you know what? Maybe I will. All this running around, my muscles probably need whatever protein I can give them.
My thoughts exactly. I haven't gotten this much exercise since Carnival.
I guess we've got a lot of extra lysine now that the parasaurs don't need the external supply.
Yeah, about that. It's not just the parasaurs. We added the antidote to the main water supply.
But that'll reach every dinosaur in the park. The lysine contingency... You're insane! Denying the dinosaurs lysine was the only safety mechanism we had to keep them out of the global ecosystem.
You've already denied them the right to breed. That's their death sentence.
Yes, but who knows how much damage they can do before then? A single brachiosaur can destroy as much jungle in one day as a whole herd of elephants. I can imagine the impact a group of them would have on a rainforest.
Do I need to remind you that there are 120 miles of ocean between Isla Nublar and the mainland? The lysine contingency was cruel and unnecessary.
What if they can swim? Or what about the pterodons?
Tell me this. Did you reverse the lysine contingency with the pteranodons?
No. My formula targets superorder Dinosauri exclusively. If I'd tried to account for the pteranodons, I might have affected other reptiles.
Oh, at least there's that.
Now that I think about it, though, targeting only pteranodons, or any one species, would be a simple change. I wouldn't even need a full lab.
Am I going to have to ask Jess to follow you into the ladies' room?
It won't come to that. If I decide to do it, I won't sneak around, and I won't involve you. I'm sorry if the way I went about it last time upset you.
Well, thanks for the apology, I guess, but this isn't about me. Do you know for a fact that none of these animals can swim?
Oh, come on, Jerry.
It's how Asian elephants migrated to Sri Lanka from India. There's precedent.
You're being ridiculous. There's no evidence sauropods were swimmers. None. All right. Supposing there's a dinosaur that can swim. I find it highly unlikely that one could make it through 120 miles of open water, through ocean currents, sharks...
Highly unlikely? 20 years ago, would you ever have predicted dinosaur cloning? Ever. 20 days ago, would you have predicted a complete failure of all our park security? Is what I fear that hard to imagine?
No. I suppose not. The remote possibility that a dinosaur could make it to the mainland is far outweighed by our responsibility to treat these animals humanely. They're here because of us.
I don't want to see these animals die. I really don't. But we all agreed to the lysine contingency. It was a prerequisite to working here.
For you, maybe. But you have to remember, Jerry, I was here before there even was a lysine contingency. Henry Wu came up with the lysine contingency, and let's not mince words, it's a kill switch, as part of his bid for the top spot. I couldn't stop it, but I never agreed to it, not even for a second.
You're still here.
Let's see. Continue my life's work, or let other people corrupt it, profit by it, and completely prevent me from even talking about it. Does that sound like a choice to you?
No. I guess not.
No matter the circumstance. You can't possibly believe it's okay to eradicate an entire species, let alone whole groups of them, regardless of how they came to be here. No one has that right.
Responsible.
Well, normally I'd agree with you. No one has the right to kill an entire species, but surely you recognize that this is a special case. We are responsible.
Careful, I'm not killing.
Yes, we are responsible. Not just for our own welfare, but for the animals as well.
I don't know, Laura. I don't know. I need to process this. I'm gonna have to tell InGen.
I understand.
Are you guys done yet?
Jess, where'd you go?
Just down the hall looking at stuff. Not that you noticed, I was gone.
I'm sorry, honey, I was distracted, but don't go off again like that, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Oof!
No good, here it comes!
What part of Saint still do you not understand? Oh god. I'm fucking this up.
Stop eating?
Apparently not. Oh! Oh, you better quicken your pace. She's gonna die. Yep. Aw. Oh. Frick.
Come on. Nice tasty dinosaur. Ever stop eating?
Stop. Oh, nice.
Move.
Oh, that was cool.
Very graceful. Come on. You know, you're about as coordinated as a three-legged mule.
I'm coordinated enough to kick you
off. Whoa, easy. I take it back. Damn, you're lucky. You ought to forget our deal and buy a lottery ticket.
The embryos.
Yeah, relax. I
You lost. You dropped them.
You lost it?
It must have fallen out.
Oh, there it is. Oh, back to Oscar.
That's right. Go. Locked. Good. If I can't open it, they can't either. There's the place to hide.
Break!
Damn! Bring it on, you!
Well...
There's the place to hide.
Okay, I'm gonna nail it this time. There we go. You didn't see anything. How the heck did you not see me there? Up the ladder! Nope, alright.
Here they come.
Done?
Hey! In case you didn't notice, it wasn't exactly a leisurely stroll over here.
You dropped it. You find it.
Hold your horses. That T-Rex is still out there.
That you let fall out of your pocket.
Sorry, I guess I was a little preoccupied with a giant, prehistoric people eater breathing down my neck.
Okay, so we know where it is. Go get it!
Yeah, I think I'll wait until our friend there leaves to find a new chew toy.
I don't know if we have time. If the embryos go bad, they're worthless.
The embryos are worthless to me if I get eaten by a damn lizard.
You're not man enough to get the embryos back. I'll do it myself.
Go for it.
The deal is, I hold on to the embryos until we reach your contact.
I know! And instead, you drop them!
Yeah, well, crap. If you're gonna use logic.
Just go! And hurry!
Damn your smarts. Like a ninja. Nice and quiet.
Damn it, Billy, get it together. Just take it slow and don't get yourself killed. Oops.
Oh. Don't move. Oh, come on, run.
Darling, what brings a nice girl like you to a place like this?
Ah, oh, damn it!
Like it. I almost fucked that up.
I got it! Somebody tell Carl Lewis I got some training tips for him!
Okay, great. Nice moves out there.
Hey, thanks.
Almost makes up for dropping it in the first place.
All those two are gonna run headlong to it. Oh!
What?
Those glowing eyes.
Eyes.
Probably a rat or something. Keep moving.
No, I saw eyes just like that before I was bitten. I won't go through that again.
Big, shiny eyes?
You saw them too?
Not here, but yeah.
go on. Get out of here.
Come on, we gotta keep moving.
No way! Not until I can see where I'm going.
Okay, we can't go back outside because of our old friend Rexy, but maybe we can get the lights on. It seems like those things, whatever they are, like to stick to the shadows. We're in luck. This looks like a power panel right here.
Oh!
Alright.
What's the holdup?
It's nothing. It's just a different, model than I'm used to, is all.
Push to close.
So, you're stuck.
And push to close.
Push to close. Close what? Well, that was my best guess.
Alright, let's try push to open.
Alright, I got it now. Close your eyes. You're about to lose your... night vision.
What's going on? Dad?
Over here, Jess. It's all right. The backup generator wasn't meant to last this long, that's all.
No, that's not it. We should have been fine for days.
How the hell was I supposed to know open meant turn everything off? I mean, it's counterintuitive.
You would know if you read the instructions.
Why don't you yell a little louder?
I forgot about the...
on the other side of the island that didn't hear you. Jeez.
God damn it.
Whatever. There's a close, right?
Alright.
There's a close, right? Close that
There's a close, right?
Yeah, that's right. Who's this? Oh, come on.
Uh-oh.
Rocking Jurassic Park's only unofficial radio station. Just a reminder before we sign off, Parklings. If you're not on the boat by 7, you're not going to be on the boat at all. I've got a little something special for all you last-minute packers out there. A personal favorite of mine. And I'll see you all on board.
Damn it, Artie.
He's not still here, is he?
No. From the sound of it, he queued up this last bit of tape and took off.
So here's a little something to get you ready to set sail.
What? Aw, come on. Oh, get him in the face. Oh.
This show is over.
Laura, you are my new favorite person.
You've forgiven me for fixing the lysine problem?
Don't push it.
Not at all.
Crap, Oscar. Did you just take one of those things out by hand?
Nima or Yoder? I guess Nima.
You're supposed to be at the crash site.
Yeah, the plan didn't factor in an angry T-Rex, so we had to change it. I didn't think to engage it in a knife fight, sorry.
We had to change the plan.
That's right. I unlocked the mystery behind the shaving cream can. Turns out, little Miss Sunshine here is smuggling dino embryos off the island.
What? I don't buy it. You don't have the skills to pull off a heist like that.
She knows her business, Oscar.
You said the same thing about that waitress in Bogota's cooking.
That wasn't her fault. Seminilla.
They're real. My client had someone on the inside, a man named Nedry. He didn't show, so they sent me to find the embryos on the backup plan.
Well?
Squares with what I know. They're searching San Jose for this Nedry guy. Thought he was on the last boat.
They can stop the search. He's dino food.
Let me guess. You have a plan.
Yeah, well, turns out these things are worth a lot of money to the right people. I mean, a lot.
Okay, you gonna do it?
You going along with her?
Hey, I'm not doing anything unless you're down. Come on, Oscar. Do you really think InGen gives a rat's ass about us? Look what happened to B-Team, to Decaf. Their families are gonna get a puny check, a gag order, and nothing else.
No, we're doing the right thing.
Do I gotta remind you we're working against the clock? There's no time to save these people and be her errand boys before this place turns to ground zero.
What do you mean, ground zero?
Nothing. We could do it, Oscar. We've got a call for another helicopter anyway, so one of us takes the eggheads back to the mainland and the other takes her to meet her contact.
Let me guess. That last part would be up to you.
You just tell InGen that I bought it like the rest of the guys they sent. Then you and I hook up later to split our cut.
I trust you, but I don't trust her.
Oh.
Look, Billy, if you want to bail, that's your business. But I was hired to do a job, and I'm gonna do it.
Oh, come on, Oscar, it doesn't have to be that way. Finishing the job is part of the plan.
So is screwing our employer. Too risky. I won't rat you out, but I don't want that kind of heat.
Sorry you feel that way, man. Let me know if you change your mind.
All right, let's move out. Take it slow and quiet.
Let's not start this again. I respect your opinion, Jerry. Although, to be honest, I'm a little surprised at your lack of regard for the animals.
It's not that I don't care about them, Laura. It's just there are so many unintended consequences that come with
don't go in there.
We can't keep this a secret,
Shoot.
Laura. We need contingency plans.
Oh, don't try it.
Monitor things outside of the park.
Where is it? I know it. Yes.
Oh. Oh, frick. Oh, it's gonna be one of those things nearby. Oh! You just ate the lighter.
Amazing. I've never seen them afraid before.
That was awesome!
No problem.
Okay, hon. Let the man breathe.
Yoder! You're alive!
We're alive? I'm surprised you guys lasted 5 minutes without me and Oscar.
Thank you.
Forget it.
That blood?
Oh my god, you're bleeding! Are you okay?
No worries. Belongs to one of them.
Killed one?
You killed one of them? With a knife? That's so badass.
Well, hey, I outran a T-Rex.
It's nothing. Just another fight.
Are you gonna get a tattoo of a raptor now? I totally would.
Not a bad idea.
You aren't fooling me.
What now?
You can pretend to be a hero all you want, but we both know what you really are.
You're right. We do.
Everyone, we have a problem.
What's wrong, Laura?
You've seen the flickering lights, now the steam eruptions. Something's gone wrong with the island's geothermal power plant.
That's not our problem.
When the power plant explodes, it will be.
It's that bad?
Everything I've read about the system says it's supposed to shut itself down if something goes wrong with the steam pressure. The fact that it hasn't means that the pressure will build unchecked. It'll pop like a balloon and take half the island with it.
Are you sure the power plant is the problem?
It's the steam that clinches it for me, Jerry. The power could fail for a lot of reasons. The steam comes straight from the power plant.
Can we get to the power plant from here? I'm completely turned around.
I saw a power plant sign over there.
It's down this way. We really ought to get moving.
How can we stop the power plant from exploding?
We have to do something, and quickly, but I won't know exactly what until we get there.
No time. Say goodbye to your dinosaurs, Doc. You can dig up the fossils later.
When the power plant explodes, it'll take us with it. Unless you have a spare helicopter ready to lift off.
Oh, this just keeps getting better and better.
Listen up. You're gonna show me the corridor that goes to the power plant. I'm gonna scout ahead and make sure there's no dinosaur party happening when we get there.
Can I come? I know I can help.
You're staying right here where I can keep an eye.
That's not a good idea.
Hey, I saved you, remember? Besides, those things are afraid of him.
You wandered off, Jess.
Oscar doesn't mind, do you? Oscar?
And he's gone.
When I saw the helicopter crash into the jungle, I thought you guys were goners.
We're fine. Hey, about before, the hostage thing? I'm sorry. I was only trying to protect myself. Me and the mercs, we worked it out.
Worked it out? How?
Don't worry about it. We're okay, for now.
You outran a T-Rex, huh, Yoder?
I sure did. You know, not everyone has the training to pull something like that off, let alone the raw speed.
I know, right? That's what I thought when I outran her yesterday. That's great! So everyone's friends now, huh?
I wouldn't put it like that.
Then how would you... No way! Did you guys make out?
We've decided that we can all work together. Let's put it that way.
Hey, Oscar's back. What'd you find, buddy?
Hallway's clear, but the door to the plant is locked.
Don't that just figure?
Either you got a key?
I'm afraid not.
How about a smoke?
I wish. I swore I had some on me, but... Jess? Something to share?
I'm sorry.
Oh, she's guilty.
I just wanted to borrow them. But then a dinosaur was there, and I threw them, and I think it ate them.
Jessica Marie Harding! First, you get caught stealing a t-shirt from the mall. Then you steal binoculars from the park and lie about it to my face. Now you've taken Laura's cigarettes? You let the raptors get to us because you wanted to smoke?
Fucking busted.
I was all nervous and anxious and stuff, and I thought it would help.
That's not the point. It's not just the smoking, it's stealing. It's not listening. Remember, the main reason you're on this island is because your mother thinks I might be able to straighten you out. Somehow.
Right. Not because you want to see me or anything. Look, you don't have to worry about me, Dad. I'm almost 15. I can take care of myself. Only you or Mom.
Oh, that's what you think.
Oh, honey, I know it feels like that. Especially at your age, but you're not an adult. You might be a young woman, physically, but emotional maturity, that takes time.
Okay? I'm sorry, Dad, but how many times have you been married? Your kids? Have you even talked to Sarah lately? This year even? Should you be lecturing anyone about emotional maturity?
Damn. Plan's gonna blow, right? We ain't got time for this after-school special crap.
Alright.
That then. It may lead to the other side of the door.
Hate to break it to you, Doc, but ain't none of us fitting through there.
Maybe.
Kid could.
I'm pretty sure that vent leads to the other side of the door.
Alright, it's the same thing.
She wants me home at 7 o'clock!
It still doesn't excuse doing things you know are wrong. That's what makes me so angry about this. I know you know better.
Yeah, but Mom doesn't, and you're not-
Missing something?
What? No. Just wondering why they left the transport cages here.
I bet.
Yeah, well, you know what? I can't bail you out if you get us eaten by dinosaurs. Don't leave my sight.
You aren't even listening to me!
So you're smoking now.
I'll see you. What, Mom didn't tell you I was stripping? That's enough, Jess. Alright.
Pretty sure that vent leads to the other side of the door.
If I talk to them.
A long talk with your mother about this.
Come on, Dad. We
Jerry,
both know that'll be
please?
Worse for you than it is for me. Marty grounded her life, so it doesn't matter if you rat me out for smoking.
It's a
Jerry,
filthy habit,
please.
Jess. It
I
can
really
kill you.
Need to speak with you.
You sound like a public service announcement.
All right, enough! I apologize. I'm sorry. Jess, we will finish this later. How can I help?
We have a situation. The only way around the door to the power plant is that vent. And Jess is the only one of us who might fit inside.
Absolutely not. My daughter has clearly shown that she can't be trusted with her own safety. She doesn't leave my sight from now on. We're just gonna have to find another solution. Jess? Jesse? Jess?
It's okay. Pretty sure the dinosaurs haven't been using that vent.
What vent? What dinosaurs? Oh my God. Jess!
What?
Well done, Jess.
Thanks.
Okay, listen up. We need to release the steam pressure to prevent any more buildup.
What are we looking for?
A power console, and probably a master release valve.
Look, Dad, I'm sorry. I was just trying to...
You were just trying to ignore everything I said! Now just stay where I can see you this time.
Okay, I will. I mean it. Sorry.
Alright, maybe up there?
That looks like the power console. Up there, at the top of the ladder. We don't want to close the circuit without charging the capacitor first.
Alright.
We can't pump the capacitor until the steam is vented. Too risky.
Alright,
Alright. Looks like we pressed open the circuit in order to turn the power off. Here goes nothing.
Press to open. That does make sense.
It does now.
We need to vent the steam before we turn the power on.
Oh.
Yeah, they're gonna have to update that sign.
No kidding.
See that large valve wheel up there? I think that's the pressure release we're looking for.
I'll handle it.
Let me try it again.
No good. I'm gonna need some help. Could you guys give me a hand with this valve? It won't budge.
Sure. We open pickle jars, too.
Okay, on three. One, two, three!
Why mean stop? It shouldn't take that much force to turn the valve. There must be some kind of motorized assist for it. If you force it, you could break something.
I'll have a look.
If there is a motor, you'll need to disconnect it before it'll turn manually.
All right.
I'm glad that lava flow is so far below us. Any closer and the heat would be unbearable.
Those blast doors are supposed to close when there's a risk of explosion.
Why aren't they closed now, then?
I don't know. I'm just glad it's not my job to explain it to the board. We need to vent the steam before we turn the power on. Not your brand, eh?
Yeah, I'm so sorry. I was desperate.
I understand. All too well, I'm afraid. Especially right now. But hey, maybe this disaster is just the push I need to quit.
Really?
Hell no. I'm so hooked I could smoke a velociraptor. I don't want to moralize, but get out if you still can.
Are you gonna go into withdrawal or something?
Huh. Already there. Hey, do you have my lighter or did the raptor eat that too? So, when do we close the circuit?
After we charge the capacitor.
Very good.
Yeah, well, you already told her the answer. How hard was that?
Are you trying to tell us something, Mr. Yoder? See that large valve wheel up there? I think that's the pressure release we're looking for.
I'll handle it.
The heck?
See See that large valve wheel up there? I think that's the pressure release we're looking for.
I'll handle it.
Totally stumped here. Okay, minor difficulty. We're back in here.
Listen up. We need to release the steam pressure to prevent any more buildup.
What are we looking for?
A power console. And probably a master release valve.
Oh, see if it works this time.
I'm sorry. I was just trying to...
You were just trying to ignore everything I said! Now just stay where I can see you this time.
Okay. I will. I mean it. Sorry.
Alright.
Look at all those transformers.
The plant produces enough power to run a small city.
Alright.
See that large valve wheel up there? I think that's the pressure release we're looking for.
I'll handle it.
Wait until I turn the power off to release the pressure. Otherwise, the system won't properly reset.
Got it.
All right.
That looks like the power console, up there, at the top of the ladder. All right. Looks like we pressed open the circuit in order to turn the power off. Here goes nothing.
Press to open, that does make sense.
It does now.
We can't pump the capacitor until the steam is vented. Too risky.
Guys, give me a hand with this valve. It won't budge.
Sure, we open pickle jars too.
Okay, on three. One, two, three.
Stop!
We got this.
Why me? It shouldn't take that much force to turn the valve. There must be some kind of motorized assist for it. If you force it, you could break something.
I'll have a look.
If there is a motor, you'll need to disconnect it before it'll turn manually. Those blast doors are supposed to close when there's a risk of explosion.
Why aren't they closed now, then?
I don't know. I'm just glad it's not my job to explain it to the board.
Allie.
Yeah, they're gonna have to update that sign.
Not your brand, eh?
Yeah, I'm so sorry. I was desperate.
I understand. All too well, I'm afraid. Especially right now. But hey, maybe this disaster is just the push I need to quit.
Really?
Hell no. I'm so hooked I could smoke a velociraptor. I don't want to moralize, but get out if you still can.
Are you gonna go into withdrawal or something?
Huh. Already there. Hey, do you have my lighter or did the raptor eat that too? We don't want to close the circuit without charging the capacitor first. See that large valve wheel up there? I think that's the pressure release we're looking for.
I'll handle it.
Things going mess up again.
I'm glad that lava flow is so far below us. Any closer and the heat would be unbearable. Looks just like a smokestack.
Oh.
That compartment there. That could house the motor we're looking for.
I'll check it out.
Yeah, we really should close the doors.
Motor's fried! Burnt out! Okay, I found what's holding the motor in.
Great, but we don't have any tools.
Don't need any. It's just a latch.
That's handy. I guess the need to yank that thing out in a hurry was anticipated.
Perfect. Let's try it again.
And turn.
That's it. The steam has been vented. All we need now is to turn the power back on.
Charge the capacitor.
You, need any help?
I'm quite capable, thank you.
One. Two. Three. Four.
Is that the...
It's the press to close light. It means the charge is pumped.
Right.
I'm going to close the circuit and turn the power back on.
Please don't blow up. Please don't blow up. Please don't blow up.
I think you'll find we have nothing to worry about.
Say that now.
What's happening?
Laura?
Nothing to worry about, huh?
It's all right, everyone. It's just a fail-safe measure to protect the plant. We probably set it off when we disconnected the motor or something else. Everything is just fine.
If you say so.
Uh-oh. Oh, now we're getting trapped in here with them. That's not gonna be good for anybody.
Run for the ladder, Nemo, before they can cut you off!
Try.
Oh, they cut me off.
The door controls, they're completely fried.
Thank you.
These doors be open manually?
I'm afraid not. The only way we can get them open is by using the controls by the doors where we came in.
I'm on it.
No! No way! That's suicide!
He's right.
The raptors wouldn't have come back if they were still afraid of you.
I'll just have to give them a new reason to be scared, Ben.
Can we at least talk about this?
You know damn well I'm the only one's got a chance to get to that control panel.
Maybe, but who says you have to go alone?
I do. Look, Billy, we gotta get these people out of here. I figure they got no chance with both of us gone.
Crap.
Okay, I want everyone to hang tight while I figure this out. You're going to be fine.
What's the plan?
Working on it. I'll let you know.
More bright ideas?
Still thinking.
Down that way. I've made jumps that wide before. All right, I want you to tempt those raptors by creeping down the ladder.
Oh, okay. Before, I thought you were nuts, but that sounds like a great plan.
You got something better?
You can always throw the doctor lady down there. That would distract them.
Don't go. You could die.
Don't count me out yet. Give me a diversion, will ya? Couple of seconds at least.
Got it.
Hey, thanks.
He makes it back.
Try not to worry. The man has skills.
I thought you hated him.
But I respect his ability. If anyone can do this, he can.
Oscar! Company!
Uh-oh.
Hey! Fuck. Hey, check this out, huh? Nice, tasty drumstick! Too slow, you dumb lizard!
Actually...
That's it. Just keep focused on Billy.
What?
Damn it.
Alright.
Actually,
that's it. Just keep focused on Billy. Damn it.
Oscar,
get on your feet, Oscar, run! check this out, huh? Nice, tasty drumstick.
I fucking suck at this.
Too slow, you dumb lizard.
Actually.
That's it. Just keep focused on Billy.
Oscar.
Was their fear response. Something about this place scares them. But even if they weren't scared, you look ready to hold them off.
Thanks. I'm glad I didn't have to.
Are you okay, Billy?
What the hell do you think?
What Oscar did was very brave. When we get back, we're gonna make sure he is duly recognized for his...
You think I care about that crap?
Let's just give him some space.
5 minutes! Just give me 5 minutes and I'll be fine. I know what you people think of us. Bunch of blue-collar grunts, right? Bunch of high school dropouts. We're replaceable.
We don't think that. We don't! Tell him!
Oscar was worth 1,000 of you, and he knew it. And he still died to save your ass. So don't tell me how you're gonna honor him. You don't deserve
to. Okay. What can we do?
Nothing. I said I'll be fine, remember? All I need is space.
I know we've got a lot on our minds, but whatever spooked those raptors might be nearby.
Laura's right. I need everyone to be alert while she and I search the room.
What is that? It smells like the jungle. Only more rotten.
Oh. That's a hand.
Jess, you don't want to see this. Nima, could you...
Yeah. Come with me, Jess. Try not to look, okay?
he's still alive.
His pulse is weak, but it's there. Look for bite marks.
Bite marks? Yes, yes, they look just like...
Just like the ones Nima had, I know. He's alive, but only technically. He's paralyzed and almost certainly brain dead. This is the Venom's final stage.
This guy's dressed a lot like you, Billy.
Does he have a tattoo on his arm? Like mine?
Yes, yes, he does.
Laura.
Eggs. It is a nest. I thought the structure looked like the nest of a cassowary, maybe an emu, but without eggs, I couldn't be sure.
Yes, but they're inside him.
If you'd asked me 5 minutes ago, I'd have told you such behavior didn't exist outside of class Insecta, but
Laura,
now...
He's a human being.
I'm sorry. You're absolutely right.
What the hell's going on over there? Is he alive or not?
He's alive, but in a comatose state. Something has laid eggs in his abdomen.
Something what?
The victim is being kept alive by...
Decaf!
I'm sorry?
The victim is Daniel Cafaro, another throwaway grunt.
Oh my god. I knew they'd gotten out somehow, but I never thought...
You about this? You knew? I'll kill you!
Oh. Oh, that's a good spot to end it. Oh! And now she's gonna die. Billy's gonna kill her. Oh, alright, well. If you liked that video, be sure to subscribe. Check my channel for more videos. And I'll see you in the next video. See ya.